Hi, I'm State Senator George Latimer. Welcome to the New York State Senate Legislative Report. In everyone's home budget, there are certain allocations for necessary expenses, from mortgage payments to a host of different things that we're accustomed to, energy costs and so forth. And one of those costs that we are accustomed to is paying for insurance in the many different parts of our lives. There's insurance on our automobiles, on our home, life insurance, health insurance, and so forth. So we have one of the stars in Albany, who is an expert in the area of insurance, with us today to talk a little bit about some of those areas that affect us living in Westchester County, living in a coastal community, and subject to hurricanes, amongst other types of things. We have with us Michael Barrett. Michael, thank you for being with us. He's president of Barrett and Associates, and amongst his areas and clients that he works with, the independent insurance brokers in New York State. So we're happy to have you here today. Let's talk a little bit from exactly where we began. We're not in hurricane season as we tape this. We're in snow season. But we always get to the point where we start hearing about hurricanes coming, and we get worried that one of these hurricanes will hit New York full force. And when it does, areas like Westchester County and the coastal communities, even the inland communities, are going to be vulnerable. What is, as you see it from an industry representative standpoint, New York State's positioning in this area? Where are we strong or weak vis-a-vis our insurance protection for our residents?
Yes, thank you, Senator. Nice to be with you, as always, to talk about these crucial issues. And first, let's remember what independent agents and brokers do for consumers. When a consumer goes to purchase insurance and they go to an independent agent or broker, that producer, they're called, can pick from a number of companies that gets the right coverage at the right price for that consumer. And then should there be a loss, whether it be a loss on an auto policy or in their home or, you know, a hurricane type of situation, the agent or broker can also help the consumer settle that loss, work with the company and the consumer to get that settled. So that's the basic function of the agent and broker. And as you note, one of the major issues the last couple of years has been the hurricanes that have hit the downstate area. And I know you've been very concerned about this issue over the years that we've known each other. And one of the real challenges for the insurance industry in settling claims as an outgrowth of hurricanes, a large number of losses at one time, has been to try to get the resources into those areas to look at the damage, work with consumers, and get them a check so they can begin to reconstruct some of their homes. One of the real problems, not your district, but you get into Queens during the last hurricane, you had Breezy Point, which devastated a lot of houses close together. Not only losses from the hurricane, water, wind, what have you, there was also a fire that destroyed a number of houses as well. And it was very difficult for the industry to get the resources into that area quickly in order to settle some of those claims. So that's one of the challenges we have as an insurance industry. We've been working with the Cuomo administration on better procedures to get those resources to consumers. And again, I know you're very concerned about that, and we'll continue to work with you as well on some of those initiatives.
There are some insurance companies, Michael, that have chosen not to write new policies in this area. Mm-hmm. Is that a broad-based trend? Is that a decision made by one or two or X number of individual companies to avoid potentially being open to the liability that might come if they're that deeply written in terms of commitments?
Yes. Some of the national companies look at their exposure, not just in New York, but right down the coast, right down to Florida, matter of fact, right around to New Orleans and that area. And they need to judge what is their exposure should some of these hurricanes hit. And they have to adjust that exposure at times. And that impacts some consumers in your area, and particularly on Long Island, as they say to themselves, well, if we're hit with a major hurricane, what is our exposure as a major insurance carrier through the whole eastern part of the country?
Are there any elements of New York's regulatory policies that should be changed in your judgment in this area? I mean, it's commonly thought that New York is the most regulated state in the nation when it comes to insurance. Does that serve as a disincentive for us to have the coverage that we need?
No, and I don't think it does. We found the Department of Financial Services that regulates the insurance industry has been very open to discussions on new products, pricing, to get some of those approved from a regulatory perspective so companies can get those products into the marketplace for consumers. So I think we have, even though it's a very stringent regulatory climate, I think it's one that appreciates private sector involvement from the companies and agents and brokers as well to get products into the marketplace.
I come out of a marketing background, and I can't help but turn on the TV and see commercials that encourage people to buy insurance online, buy insurance through other mechanisms, through national organizations, and there's no local representative there. Is that putting pressure on the small business men and women that are insurance brokers in these communities that serve that independent selective function?
Yes, it does, Senator, and that is a great question, because some of the ads that you're talking about are based just on price and don't necessarily reflect the coverages that consumers may need. So this is, and you have some of these companies that you're talking about putting millions of dollars into these marketing campaigns. So when you go to an independent agent or broker, as I mentioned a few minutes ago, they can look at the right price for the right coverage. When you look at an ad online, 1-800-INSURANCE, whatever it may be, and they're just talking about costs, again, it may not reflect the correct coverage that you need on your home or your auto or for your life insurance for that matter. So it's a soundbite that really does not serve consumers well, we think.
And of course, it's difficult too for us as consumers, even the most intelligent amongst us, to really understand all of the different details that are involved when we contract for insurance. I mean, we'll see a form that we sign, and it's unless we're a lawyer trained in that particular area to read it, to analyze it before we sign it, sometimes in the purchase of a house, there's a host of these kind of things we're doing one after the other after the other. Who guides us through that process?
Well, your agent or broker can guide you through that process, and you're correct. A consumer gets an insurance policy in the mail. It's a stack of it's the policy itself, different disclosures about coverages and what have you. And a lot of people don't read it, but it's important to when a consumer is working with their agent or broker to sit down and say, okay, here's what you're getting, here's what the agent brokers, the kind of coverage they're getting for you from the company that they're going to place you with, and to go through some of those important coverages that consumers need to know about.
The competitive market for the individual insurance broker, is that been static over the last number of years? Has it increased in levels of competition? I can't imagine it's decreased with all the different other sources and reasons. Is it harder for these agencies to make a go of it compared to what might have been the case 30-40 years ago?
I don't think it is. I mean, it just as in a lot of other businesses, there's a trend towards consolidation and merging, if you will, of some of the smaller agencies. But I think we have a very competitive marketplace generally in the state, very competitive marketplace as it relates to agents and brokers. I mean, consumers can go online and find a whole host of agents and brokers in their community that offer coverage. So it is very competitive, but there is a tendency for this consolidation that's going on as well. And you see some of the smaller agents and brokers are having maybe a little more difficulty.
Do the brokers handle all different types of insurance products, or do they specialize in certain areas? Obviously, it's different based on the individual agency. But we've obviously had now in the society over the last 5-7 years major discussion about health insurance issues and the national program and a host of other programs that have been out there. We've talked a little bit primarily about property and casualty. Is that expertise spread out over which sectors of the industry?
Well, you do have some specialization out there, and you have some agents and brokers have a certain weighting, if you will, of they might write commercial products for businesses. They might have an overweight in that area and a specialty in that area. But most agents and brokers will handle commercial products, personal lines products, homeowners and auto, and that type of thing. health insurance and life insurance as well, with different weightings about how much business that they are going to write in their operation. One of the good things is if a consumer calls an agent or broker and let's say wants to purchase health insurance, and the agent doesn't necessarily, let's say they don't write health insurance, there's a network there where even that agent or broker can help the consumer find the correct person to talk to at another operation that's going to help them get that health coverage they may need. Or, as a matter of fact, be a counselor to them and help them purchase it from the New York State of Health, the Health Exchange here in New York State as well. So those connections and that ability to channel the consumer to the right place is again, one of the hallmarks of agents and brokers.
And how competitive is the environment for the insurance providers, the major names that we hear about? And obviously, they're trying to market their products through mm-hmm. these independent agents. Does that create a certain level of competition that becomes difficult for the individual agent to keep on top of? I assume there's certain incentives from time to time and mm-hmm. certain plans and programs that offer certain things at certain prices. And it must be quite a buffet table of options at any point in time.
There absolutely is, and among the insurance companies. And agents, again, as I mentioned, usually represent 3, 4, 5 or more companies in their office and work with those companies. Certain companies have specialties, if you will, on the type of business they write. There's one large company based in New Jersey that writes, high-value homes along the coast. That's their niche. That's their specialty. Right. Other companies, some of the more common names you would hear, would write normal, what's called homeowners policies, auto policies, things like that. So there is that competition, and the agent can pick through those companies with that have the ability to provide the right product for the consumer.
Since we're here in Albany, we ought to talk about what the state legislature is dealing with, either in the budget or in general legislation, that matters most to the people you represent.
One of the issues that's really coming to the forefront is the we call the sharing economy, ride sharing, car sharing. You have Uber and Lyft and some of those companies that are trying to set up initially in New York City to have consumers go on an app and get somebody to pick them up in a private car. And the real challenge there from an insurance perspective is that if somebody has a personal auto policy, like Michael Barrett has a personal auto policy, but I get involved with Uber, where I'm picking Senator Latimer up that's a business, right. So the real challenge there is where does the personal coverage leave off and where does the commercial coverage kick in? And that's a real debate. And I think something consumers should be aware of as well. If that driver is in an accident and the consumer is injured, is there insurance coverage?
And so do we need to legislate in this area to sort of tighten up that which is, sort of a new development in the field?
You may have to do that. And there's going to be some very aggressive discussions this year on how to do that. I think one of the other issues that's around in the broader segment of our society is cybersecurity.
Mm-hmm. Very important.
And the Department of Financial Services is looking at some initiatives to work with insurance carriers and banks to safeguard consumer information.
Right.
I think there's a trickle down to agents and brokers on that as well. If you say, anybody that's working with an insurance carrier has to handle information in a certain way.
Right.
Does that impact the small business people that I represent? I think potentially it does, but an important issue for society and for the insurance industry as well.
We've been talking with Michael Barrett, who is president of Barrett & Associates, based here in Albany, representing independent insurance brokers and agents. And Michael, I know we'll have more conversations as we go forward. Perhaps we'll have you back on TV and have a chance to chat a little bit more about wherever our issues progress us.
Terrific. Love to do it, Senator. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you. And thank you for watching. If you have any questions, any issues that you want to address to us, and particularly in the next few weeks until we reach the budget deadline of March 31st, hopefully by March 31st, feel free to contact me at our district office located at 222 Grace Church Street in Port Chester. Our phone number is 914-934-5250. Or you can reach us email, latimer@nysenate.gov. I'm State Senator George Latimer. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time for the New York State Senate Legislative Report.